Gotta take one, Joey.
What's up, guys? Joey here. If you get the
You call me a saint, but you know I'm a stranger, a willing aid.
What's up, guys? Joey here. If you get the and I'm happy today. I'm happy about three things. One, I'm happy that we now have our Christmas tree set up here in the studio. Two, I'm happy that the Rockets won against the Blazers today. And three, I'm happy that we finally got our Samsung Galaxy Fold here in the office. So, this is our unboxing and hands-on. Let's check out this amazing device that costs a lot of money. Alright, so first up, this is a pretty fancy box. You see the Galaxy text here folds on itself. It's very nice. So it opens like this. So this is the outer box. Inside the outer box, we have the main box over here. And we lift up the lid. There we have it. This is the Galaxy Fold. Oh my god. You have to see this. Okay, so I want to play with it already, but let's set it aside. Let's see what else is inside the box. Underneath the fold itself, we usually say underneath the phone itself. I said underneath the fold itself. All right, underneath that, of course it says unfold the future, make your Galaxy Fold. In this smaller box, we got our manual, quick start guide, warranty, and some instructions. We get our SIM ejector tool, and okay, this is freaky. This is a case that comes in two parts. That's weird. Okay, let's set this aside for now. And of course, we all automatically assume that, wow, you're paying like 100,000 pesos for a phone, but you don't just get the phone in the box. You also get an included pair of Galaxy Buds. We have our fast charger. We have the OTG adapter that's type C to type A. And in this little box over here, we got the type C cable and some more tips for our Galaxy Buds. But enough of all of that. That's just the accessories. Let's set this all aside for now because this is the part I'm most excited about. Actually, just checking out the famous folding phone. Ooh, for the first time. Oh. Yeah, I mean, okay. First off, definitely we're not the first channel to check out this phone, but on a personal level, this is my first time to see a Galaxy Fold in person. It's freaky, man. It's freaky. The feeling is so, it feels so wrong to fold this screen. There we have it. You wanna try?
Oh!
Fold it, fold it.
Can I just... Bye-bye.
What the... Man, it's so freaky.
There's like already fold right here.
But yeah, that's part of the screen. So yeah, as Justine mentioned, you can see a crease in the middle of the two halves of the display. Or by the way, let's get this out of the way. I'm gonna put on the included case right now. It's like a carbon fiber type of finish. It's really nice. And nice touch over there. You guys can see there's a little fold logo over here. Yeah, it's a nice case. Wow. Man. All right, so after all of that, I have calmed myself down. I actually do have some initial impressions already. Let's just treat this like any other phone despite its folding display. So when it's folded up, on the cover side, you have a 4.6-inch Super AMOLED display with a 720p resolution. Up top, you get a 10-megapixel selfie camera. On the right side, you have the fingerprint scanner that's side-mounted. You have the power button, volume rocker. At the bottom, loudspeaker, Type-C port, main microphone. On top, I'm guessing another speaker, another microphone. Flipping it open, there's the 7.3 3-inch dynamic AMOLED display that has two front cameras. That's a 10-megapixel main and 8-megapixel depth sensor for live focus. At the back, that's the same setup as pretty much as the Galaxy Note 10. 12-megapixel main, 12-megapixel telephoto, and 16-megapixel ultrawide, plus an LED flash. It's a pretty thick phone, especially even with the case off. It's a thick phone. It's also very long, but it's kind of narrow. So, I mean, granted, yeah, I'm a big guy, but doing the pocket test, it's not too bad over here. It's like having one of those old Motorola Razr phones while they're open inside your pocket. All right, so this thing is gonna be amazing for things like, for example, this is Netflix on right now. I'm watching on the small screen, and then go boom, it goes on the big screen. It's amazing for things like that. Netflix, videos in general, playing games, being able to flip to a bigger screen that's a tablet size, 7 inches. In situations like this where you're not moving along, but if you're an active person, like someone who maybe commutes a lot, maybe you drive, maybe you travel a lot, I'm not too sure about its viability as a phone, because when you're using it as a phone, it's such a bulky device with such a small screen on the cover. To get the full fold experience, you'll have to be seated down and you'll want to be able to use it as a tablet. So that's the theme, I guess, of this video. My first impression of the Galaxy Fold, not as good as a phone, but amazing as a tablet. Is it for everybody? Of course not. It might not be a good daily driver for most people because of just the way it functions. Granted, aside from the hefty price tag, but yeah, that's the main reason why this might not be the device for most people. Nonetheless, I'm excited, if you can't tell. I'm excited to take this for our full review to see what it's got. So, if you guys are interested, this guy is now officially available in the Philippines. It's priced at 109,990 pesos. That's for the Galaxy Fold. But, you know, you do get free Galaxy Buds in the box. So that's SRP in the Philippines, 109,990. It's also available in a planned form from either Smart or Globe. That pretty much wraps it up. So again, guys, stay tuned for our full review of the Galaxy Fold. Let us know what you think about this crazy expensive, crazy, crazy phone in the comments down below. Do you think this is the future? Do you think this is the future? I don't know, we'll see. Now, if you enjoyed this video, please do drop a like, subscribe to our channel for more content, hit the bell icon to miss any future uploads, and be sure to visit yugatech.com for the latest tech news and reviews. This has been Joey, and I'll be folding out.